But this is what we're going to keep our eye on just in case it does start to kick up a little bit. And as far as the probabilities are concerned, it really trails off pretty dramatically down to almost a 60% chance by 8 p.m., 30% chance as most of the storm moves out fairly rapidly. As a matter of fact, here it is on FutureScan. Looks like Clinton, Butler, Belton is about as far north as this last band will move through, but in a few hours it's gone and skies start to clear out once again, and that's not going to be a good sign either. One above in the next few hours, a north wind at 10 to 20, and the light snow will persist. And remember, we showed you this graphic on Friday. The more sleet you have in your neighborhood, your specific totals, that means less on the ground with regard to snow. But everybody has to be worried about phase two of the storm. That's the colder air. Pete.
All right, you know, that's right. As the snow tapers off, Brian, we're going to be dealing with the Arctic grip. It's going to be over us for at least 24 to 36 hours. Now, some of the numbers around the area, you mentioned 3 degrees at KCI. Well, downtown's at 5 degrees. And look at some of the temperatures around the area. I mean, look at this. 2 degrees in Maryville, Butler's at 5 degrees, Clinton at 4. You factor in a strong north wind, 10, 15, even up to 20 mile per hour winds, and you get a wind chill factor, how about this, minus 15 right now in Kansas City. And by the way, as we talk about the Arctic grip, the record low for tomorrow's date is minus 1 back in 1978. Brian?
Oh, that's not going to feel that great at all. Looking at the 7-day forecast, we are talking about that bitter cold to be around and shattering that record of 7 below, 13 and partly sunny. We go to 3 to 28 degrees on Tuesday. Another chance of snow, lighter, not going to last as long, not as strong. Back to 36 degrees then. We thaw out, melting some of that snow Thursday into Friday, being back to near normal temperatures by next weekend, 26 in the morning, afternoon high of 42. 50s, really? Seriously? Could be. 29 in the morning, afternoon high of 54 degrees. But again, it looks like we still have a little bit of snow for some of our counties, not much more added to most of us, and still have to worry about the emphasis on bitter cold winds, which is almost dangerous if you're talking 15 to 20 below zero.